Mr. Speaker, for the purposes of debate only, I yield the customary 30 minutes to the distinguished gentleman from Oklahoma, pending which I yield myself such time as I may consume. During consideration of this resolution, all time yielded is for the purposes of debate only. I ask unanimous consent that all members be given 5 legislative days to revise and extend their remarks.
Without objection.
Mr. Speaker, today the Rules Committee, yesterday the Rules Committee met and reported a closed rule, House Resolution 41, providing for consideration of H.Res. 24, impeaching Donald John Trump, President of the United States, for high crimes and misdemeanors. The rule provides 2 hours of debate equally divided and controlled by the chair and ranking member of the Committee on the Judiciary. The rule also provides that upon adoption of H.Res. 24, H.Res. 40 is hereby adopted. Finally, the rule extends recess instructions, suspension authority, and same-day authority through February 11, 2021. Mr. Speaker, we are debating this historic measure at an actual crime scene, and we wouldn't be here if it weren't for the President of the United States. On Wednesday, January 6, Congress gathered here to fulfill our constitutional duty, tallying the Electoral College victory of President-elect Biden and Vice President-elect Harris after a free and fair election. This is largely a ceremonial role for the Congress, one that sends a message to the world that democracy in the United States persists. But at a rally just a mile and a half down Pennsylvania Avenue, Donald Trump and his allies were stoking the anger of a violent mob. A member of this very body proclaimed on that stage, "Today is the day American patriots start taking down names and kicking ass." Trump's personal attorney, Rudy Giuliani, called for trial by combat. Then Donald Trump told the crowd, "We're going to have to fight much harder. You will never take back our country with weakness." Even though, according to his own administration, that this election was the most secure in our history, Donald Trump repeated his big lie that this election was an egregious assault on democracy. Vice President Pence, he said, was going to have to come through for us. Trump then told this mob to walk down to the Capitol. The signal was unmistakable. These thugs should stage a coup so Donald Trump can hang on to power. The people's will be damned. This beacon of democracy became the site of a vicious attack. Rioters chanted, "Hang Mike Pence," as a noose and gallows were built a stone's throw from the Capitol steps. Capitol police officers were beaten and sprayed with pepper spray. Attackers hunted down lawmakers to hold them hostage or worse. Staff barricaded doors. People sent text messages to their families to tell them they loved them. They thought they were saying goodbye, Mr. Speaker. This was not a protest. This was an insurrection. This was a well-organized attack on our country that was incited by Donald Trump. Domestic terrorists broke into the United States Capitol that day, and it's a miracle more people didn't die. As my colleagues and I were being evacuated to safety, I never, ever will forget what I saw when I looked into the eyes of those attackers right in the Speaker's lobby there. I saw evil, Mr. Speaker. Our country came under attack, not from a foreign nation, but from within. These were not protesters. These were not patriots. These were traitors. These were domestic terrorists, Mr. Speaker. And they were acting under the orders of Donald Trump. Now, some of my colleagues on the other side have suggested that we just move on from this horror. But to gloss over it would be an abdication of our duty. Others on the Republican side have talked about unity. But we can't have unity without truth and without accountability. And I'm not about to be lectured by people who just voted to overturn the results of a free and fair election. America was attacked, and we must respond, even when the cause of this violence resides at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. Each of us took an oath last week. It wasn't to a party, and it wasn't to a person. We vowed to defend the Constitution. The actions of Donald Trump have called each of us to fulfill that oath today. I pray that we rise to this responsibility, because every moment Donald Trump is in the White House, our nation, our freedom is in danger. He must be held to account for the attack on our Capitol that he organized and he incited. I solemnly urge my colleagues to support this rule and the underlying article. The damage this building sustained can be repaired, Mr. Speaker. But if we don't hold Donald Trump accountable, the damage done to our nation could be irreversible. I reserve the balance of my time.
Gentleman from Massachusetts reserves. Gentleman from Oklahoma is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, before I begin my formal remarks, I want to ask for God's blessing and protection on you, for my friend Mr. McGovern, for all who come to this chamber today to speak and to vote, for our wonderful staff that makes this possible, and most especially for the men and women of the Capitol Police and the other affiliated law enforcement agencies that are here to protect everybody and to make sure that this proceeding can go forward. With that, Mr. Speaker, I want to thank the gentleman from Massachusetts, my very good friend, distinguished chairman of the Rules Committee, Mr. McGovern, for yielding me the customary 30 minutes, and I yield myself such time as I may consume. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Well, Mr. Speaker, today is a sad day for all of us. For me personally, for the Rules Committee, for the entire House of Representatives, and most certainly for the American people. For the second time in 13 months, we're meeting to discuss the impeachment of the President of the United States. Our meeting today does not arise in a vacuum and comes at what I hope and pray is the end of a tumultuous period for our country. Less than 1 week ago, Congress met to certify the results of the 2020 presidential election. What started out as peaceful protest turned into a riot as an untold number of individuals stormed the Capitol building. Six people died as a result of this mob. And it's only by the grace of God and the brave acts of the U.S. Capitol Police, the Washington, D.C. Metropolitan Police, the FBI, the ATF, and other responding agencies that there was not more bloodshed. Violent acts such as these have no place in our republic. These shocking and sobering events rest high on our minds today, as well they should. Certainly January 6, 2021 will live in my memory as the darkest day during my time of service as a member of this House. After these grave events, we as a nation and as an institution have an opportunity to come together. President Trump has conceded the 2020 election. Congress has certified the results of the election. And next Wednesday, President-elect Biden will be sworn in as the President of the United States. Congress and the nation can move forward knowing that the political process was completed as designed and that the constitutional framework that has governed our republic since 1789 held firm. But instead of moving forward as a unifying force, the majority in the House is choosing to divide us further. With only a week to go in his term, the majority is asking us to consider a resolution impeaching President Trump. And they do so knowing full well that even if the House passes this resolution, the Senate will not be able to begin considering these charges until after President Trump's term ends. Mr. Speaker, I can think of no action the House can take that's more likely to further divide the American people than the action we are contemplating today. Emotions are clearly running high, and political divisions have never been more apparent in my lifetime. We desperately need to seek a path forward, healing for the American people. So it's unfortunate that a path to support healing is not the path the majority's chosen today. Instead, the House is moving forward erratically with a truncated process that does not comport with the modern practice and that will give members no time to contemplate the serious course of action before us. In every modern impeachment inquiry, an investigation and committee action has preceded bringing an impeachment resolution to the floor. In part, this is to ensure that members have the full facts, the opportunity to engage expert witnesses, and have a chance to be heard. It also provides due process to the President of the United States. And again, in every modern impeachment inquiry, the President has been given an opportunity to be heard in some form or another. This is necessary in order to ensure that the American people have confidence in the procedures the House is following. It's also necessary, not because of the President's inappropriate and reckless words are deserving of defense, but because the presidency itself demands due process in the impeachment proceedings. Unfortunately, the majority's chosen to race to the floor with a new article of impeachment, foregoing any investigation, any committee process, or any chance for members to fully contemplate this course of action before proceeding. Professor Jonathan Turley is correct when he called this a, quote, dangerous snap impeachment, an impeachment that effectively would go to a vote without the deliberation or inquiries of the traditional hearing. Professor Turley also noted that, quote, the damage caused by the rioters this week was enormous. However, it will pale in comparison to the damage from a new precedent of a snap impeachment, unquote. If the majority is seeking consensus, this is hardly the way to create it. The majority's failing to provide the House with an opportunity to review all the facts, which are still coming to light, to discuss all the evidence, to listen to scholars, to examine the witnesses, and to consider precedents. This is not the type of robust process we have followed for every modern impeachment, and the failure to do so does a great disservice to this institution and to this country. Mr. Speaker, I can think of nothing that will cause further division more than the path the majority is now taking. Rather than looking ahead to a new administration, the majority is again seeking to settle scores against the old one. Rather than seeking to heal America, they are seeking to divide us more deeply. And rather than following the appropriate processes the House has used in every modern impeachment, the majority is rushing to the floor, tripping all over themselves in their rush to impeach the president a second time. What's worse, though the majority seems to believe that this course of action is self-evident, and that's simply not the case. I have to tell them it's not. Members that have reviewed the same conduct and have come to dramatically different conclusions. Legal scholars like Professor Turley and Professor Alan Dershowitz, both of whom condemned the president's statements, believe that his statements are not impeachable. I know other scholars have different points of view. Given this difference of opinion, shouldn't we have a better process than this? Shouldn't we have a chance to examine witnesses, discuss the matter with legal scholars, and consider this in committee? On a matter as grave and consequential as impeachment, shouldn't we follow the same process we have used in every modern impeachment rather than rushing to the floor? On behalf of generations of Americans to come, we need to think more clearly about the consequences of our actions today. The fact of the matter is, Mr. Speaker, there is no reason to rush forward like this, other than the very obvious fact that there are only 7 days left until a new president takes office. But what's worse, as Professor Dershowitz has pointed out, because of the Senate's rules, the case cannot come to trial in the Senate until 1 p.m. on January the 20th, 1 hour after President Trump leaves office. This is an ill-advised course, in my opinion, Mr. Speaker. Even Senator Joe Manchin, a Democrat, agrees. Senator Manchin is quoted this week as having said, quote, I think this is so ill-advised for Joe Biden to be coming in, trying to heal the country, trying to be the president of all the people when we're going to be so divided and fighting again. Let the judicial system do its job, unquote. So what then is the point of the rush to impeach? We are coming off a horrific event that resulted in 6 deaths. We have an opportunity to move forward, but we cannot if the majority insists on bringing the country through the trauma of another impeachment. It will carry forward into the next president's term, ensuring that he will struggle to organize his administration. What's worse, it will continue to generate the bitterness so many of us have opposed. Why put us through that when we can't actually resolve this before the end of the president's term? Mr. Speaker, I think my colleagues in the majority need to think about this more soberly. We need to recognize we are following a flawed process. We need to recognize that people of goodwill can differ. We need to recognize that while the House may be done with this matter after today's vote, it will not be done for the country, it will not be done for the Senate, and it will not be done for the incoming Biden administration. The House's action today will only extend the division longer than necessary. Finally, Mr. Speaker, I would note that there are other remedies that can be pursued. The President is expected to face litigation over his role in last Wednesday's events. There will be criminal proceedings against the perpetrators, and I hope all of those who stormed the Capitol will be brought to justice. And some members have proposed an alternative procedure, censuring the president, which could garner significant bipartisan support in the House. I do not think impeachment is a wise course, Mr. Speaker. I would urge my friends in the majority to reconsider. There's still time to choose a different path, one that leads to reconciliation and hope for a better and brighter days. With that, I urge opposition to the rule, and I reserve the balance of my time.